Oh.
So, how did it go? It was like the second most possible outcome in my head that would happen. What happened was she knew already and she doesn't like me. That was like the second most likely outcome in my head going into it. The first most likely outcome was that she didn't know and she doesn't like me. Basically, I had no confidence that she liked me at all. So, it all worked out. Yeah. Honestly, I'm pretty happy with how it went. It wasn't awkward, or I didn't think it was that awkward at all. I'm just happy. Honestly, I'm not sure if I'm ready for a relationship, and I'm not sure if I have the time for a relationship. Yeah. Yeah. I'm cool with it. I'm cool with what happened. Still friends, of course. Yeah, I don't know what else to say. New microphone. I'm using a new microphone. Yay. Well, I don't know what I'm doing. Yeah, so basically, I'll walk up to her, right? And I'm like, how's life? She's like, it's alright. And I'm like, did you watch my video? Right? She said, yes. She said that she watched all my videos. And I was like, did you figure it out? She said, yeah. I've had it figured out for a while. And I was like, well, okay, that makes my life a whole lot easier. Which, I mean, the whole point of this wasn't to get into a relationship. It's more of a, I need to, like, confess. Like, I need to say the words, I like you, to her. That's all I wanted. Whatever else happens, happens, but, like, that's just what I wanted to do, and I did it, and I'm happy with it. And there's no bad blood or anything. There's nothing. It's all good. So I'm happy about it. Sure, it might have been nice to get into a relationship, but like, eh. There's pros and cons. Yeah. So, it's all good. I'm not sure if I'm gonna edit this. I went into this thinking I'm not gonna edit this at all. Because, I don't know. If I edit it and make it seem like, if I take out the gaps in between words, like, you know, like a minute ago, I just had like a whole 20 seconds of just nothing. If I take out gaps like that, it doesn't sound like I'm a person. It just seems like, I don't know, it's over edited. It feels more like a person if, like, I leave it raw, I guess. So, like, I'm not sure if I'm gonna edit this. Because, I mean, that was a 20 second gap, so I don't know. Yeah. I'm cool with all of it. I'm honestly cool with it. Walking home today, I was like, I've never felt better in my life. I'm not sure if that's true, but I feel really freaking good right now. Yeah. Yeah. I'm not sure where to go from here. It doesn't even feel like summer yet. Because, I mean, I keep telling myself. Oh, by the way, this is the last day of school. Today is the last day of school. But I don't call it summer yet. I'm not set. Right now, at this current moment in time, at 1:32 p.m. on the 6th of what? June? June 2019. I am not saying that it's summer yet because I have to go perform at the graduation ceremony, and then tomorrow morning there's like a not marching band. No, there's like a band orchestra, like the band room cleanup kind of thing, like prepare the room for like summer storage. So I'm gonna help over there too. Don't know how long it'll take. Maybe like an hour and a half. Maybe. Probably less. And after that happens, then it's summer. But right now, it's not summer yet. So I don't. I mean, like, okay, it hit me a couple times. Like, maybe three or four times now. That's like, I don't have to worry about, like, anything anymore. which is totally not true. Like, I still have to worry about, like, how well I did in the SAT, which, by the way, I think I did really well. and, like, college, because I seriously procrastinated on that. It's, like, the one thing I, like, really hard procrastinated on, ever, I think. Yeah, I can't think of anything else I procrastinated this hard on. I hope that this is all, like, understandable what I'm saying, and I'm not just wasting, like, 5.5 minutes of footage, or recording, whatever. Yeah. I've been listening to a lot of RayZero soundtrack recently. RayZero is an anime. The RayZero soundtrack is actually pretty good. I like it. So, sad. It's just good. I just love it. This morning, I was listening to Requiem of Silence. If I can get a download link for it, I might put it in the video. In the background, that might be what you're listening to right now. I don't know. yeah, I don't know. It's like seven minutes long. But I mean, okay, so I tried putting like band and orchestral music in videos before. And the thing is, like, there's too broad dynamic range. Like, the softest of the softs to like the loudest of the louds is way too big of a range. So like, sometimes like you can barely hear the music at all, and then sometimes like you can't even hear my voice over the music. Yeah, so yeah, we'll see. Cause like there is a point at some point where it's like kind of loud, but it actually might be like 30 seconds ago. I don't know. Whatever. Yeah. Oh god, I'm sidetracked so much. Summer. Yeah, I feel a lot of weight lifted off me. Because, like, honestly, I was focusing more on the confession than finals today. Or, like, I didn't study at all for the two finals I had today. Instead, I focused on making the video, the Heartbroken Maya video, and worrying about the confession. That's all I focused on, instead of studying for finals. I don't know if Crush understands how important this was to me. I texted her, I was like, hey, can we talk? It's kind of important. Kinda. I said kinda important. She already knew, of course, but like, I said kinda. yeah. So, honestly, it was really important. I said thank you a couple times, right? I don't know if she understood. I mean, I know she understood what I said, but I don't know if she, like, understood why I was saying thank you. This means a lot to me. Honestly, it does. Yeah. Should I stop calling her crush? I mean, I can't say her real name. That's just against my policy. So, like, I don't know. Ex-crush. No, heck no. No. That just sounds bad. I don't know. I feel like if I keep calling her crush, then I won't get over it. And I'll just, like, keep liking her, which is not good. That's not good. So, I don't know. I'll figure it out. I don't know yet. Yeah, school's out? I don't know. Right, so, okay. I was listening to Requiem of Silence this morning, right? And, like, my mom and our roommate were like, what such dramatic music 4 in the morning? Not at 4 in the morning, but, like, why are you listening to such dramatic music in the morning? And they had no idea. Like, they don't know yet, I confess. I don't know. I mean, I'm not gonna tell roommate. He doesn't have to know anything about that. But, like, I might tell my mother. Mother dear. I don't know. I'm not gonna, like, say any names, of course, or anything. But, like, she doesn't know I had this plan at all. So, maybe. I don't know. I'll see if I feel like telling her. I might edit this out. I don't know if I want Crush to know this. Yeah, I'm just gonna keep calling her Crush for the rest of the video. And also, I think she's watching this, so. Hi. how's life? I said that way too many times this week. it's all good. It's fine. Don't feel bad if you do. I don't know why I said that. I mean, yeah, okay. Yeah. Graduation is in 3 hours, 20 minutes. I don't know why it was so specific. They just said a few hours from now. Yeah. It's just not summer yet. But it is summer. But school's out. But it's not summer yet. Okay. Montages. Smash montages are coming. Eventually. Give me like half a week from tomorrow. Probably something will be up. Have some ideas for character combinations, yada yada. Crush might be gone now. If we're not, hi. okay. Going to China for orchestra. Oakland Youth Symphony Orchestra. It's gonna be hot. I don't know what I'm saying. I don't want to end the video. I feel like there's way more to say. Oh, right. History. All right. Okay. So, I told her I liked her from, like, middle of freshman year. And, I mean, that's kind of true. I mean, I remember, like, in math class, looking back, seeing a friend of mine right behind me, and behind him was Crush, right? I think I looked back more than usual. First off, because like me and friend talked a lot. Second off, because Crush is right behind him, and I want to see her face. I'm so terrible. I hate myself. But this is the truth. Truth hurts. Truth is cheesy. Truth. Yeah, it's truth. So I remember doing that, and I know that was in freshman year. So I was like, okay, I probably liked her somewhere in freshman year. And then sophomore year rolls around, right? I'm like, okay. I want to give her a hint that I like her, right? So, I come up with the idea of on the last day of school, last year, sophomore year, right? So, I'm not sure if she remembers, but I did two songs. Okay, the final for ASL was we had to sign a song in front of the class. Like, we had to, like, translate the song into American Sign Language and then sign it in front of the class with the music. I did two. The funny thing is, I learned the second one, like, the day before. And it was dedicated to her, I guess. Because, like, I wanted, at the very end, he goes like, oh. And, like, the whole idea was, I make eye contact and hold it for, like, the entirety of it. I'm not sure how this would be a message of I like you, but I don't know, I'm stupid. I can't say I was stupid because I probably am still stupid. So I'll just say I'm stupid. That was the first thing. And what went wrong about that is that she was looking at my hand instead of my face. Which, actually, you should be looking at the signer's face, not their hand. And just use, like, peripheral vision or something. Apparently. I don't know. I'm not in ASL anymore, so I don't have to worry about it. Crush, if you're still here, I don't know if you watched it yet, but like, I made a video on why I quit ASL, so if you don't know why I quit, or you didn't watch it yet, go watch it. If you already watched it, I'm sorry for wasting that 20 seconds, okay, whatever. Not editing this video, right, and then the second thing was, I'd leave my phone book, or I need my phone number in her year. I can't talk. I would leave my phone number in her yearbook, and she didn't have a yearbook. And I was like, "Well, okay, it fan A, fan B both failed. Okay, let's go." I learned about Facebook Messenger later, so I can text her now. But like, the plan failed. Okay. yeah. So I went into the summer, like, alright, well, I guess I'll try again next year, right? Day one of school, Mrs. ASL teacher says no ASL romances. And at that point, I'm just like, why? You're telling me I waited this long just to have to wait another 9 months. I love everything. I love everything. Yeah, so my whole mindset throughout the year was like, use this time to get her to like me. And mission failed. I don't know how I thought I would do it. Whatever. At some point I was just like, yeah, I'm just gonna tell her instead. I don't have to worry about like getting into a relationship or not. You know? I was like, I'm just gonna say, hey, I like you. Or not that casually, but like, I did what I did today of just like saying the words I like you to her, and that's it. And not worrying about what happens after. I don't know when that became my consensus or like my goal, but whatever. At some point in the year, there was this thing called a garden gram, right? Because they're like rose grams, right? And then they ran out of roses, so they went to like the gardening club or something. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for my ignorance. I just forget. I think it's gardening club or smart environment club. It might be smart environment club. I'm not sure. And they were selling like potted plants, which are actually like way better than roses. What the heck? Like you get a whole pot and a planted like flower. That's so much better than a rose. Like than a rose. You have to like get a vase for a rose. Whatever. I bought a garden gram for her. I did not put my name on it because, you know, no ASL romances. Yeah, so, but the people at the booth knew who I was, and they saw her name, and I was like, "Welp, it's over. Like, it's over. Everything's ruined. You know, like, nothing goes right ever for me." So, and it was super awkward because I forgot to pay them, and they were like, "Hey, you forgot to pay." And I was like, oops," and I walked back. It was super awkward. Yeah, so that happened. And then, yeah. So she apparently knew because, like, her brother told her, because her friends told her brother. So, that's great. Yeah, really, actually, if I didn't buy the garden gram, things would have been so different today. But I did, because I was like, hey, I saw it, and I was like, hey, okay, sure, let's do it. Yeah, this is what happened. Yeah, so that's basically how it went. Oh, right. You could just say like, but you could just disregard the no ASL romances rule and just like break the rules and be like, hey, I don't care about your rules. I'm gonna have a relationship. I don't want to be that guy who breaks the rule the year it was set. Like, I don't want to be that guy. There's two boys in ASL 3. And, like, what are the odds that one of them has to break the rule? Like, why? You know, I don't want to be that guy. So, I didn't do it until now. And I was like, a couple months ago, I was thinking about it. I was like, what are my options? I could be like a couple days before the last day of school, because at that point, it's like, who cares? It's not like we're gonna like, if we did get into a relationship, we wouldn't break up within like 3 days or whatever, right? So I was like, maybe at any point in the last day, last week of school, right? Okay. And I was like, or just do the last day of school and just follow the rule completely, or next year, and that, or over the summer. I don't like the sound of anything but the last day of school, so I went with the last day of school, and here we are. 2.5 years. Yeah. And for whatever reason, despite being turned down politely, I don't feel bad. I feel good. Which I'm not sure what that means about me. Whatever. It's been like 20 minutes now. 20. Okay. Yeah. I'm done with Heartbroken Maya. I made a joke with myself, right? I would just be like, my last name starts with M, right? So it'd be like, Heartbroken, my last name. And then there's also another piece called Yellow After the Rain, right? But instead, it'd be like, Yellow After the Her Name, because like the first part of her name is like, it's similar to, it's not similar to rain, but like, it's like a weather, I guess. It's like rainy, it's sunny, it's hazy. Like the first part of her name, the first syllable is like a weather, right? So it'd be like Heartbroken my last name and Yellow After the her first name. I don't know, I'm stupid. I realized that, I was like, ha ha, ha 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 ha, that's funny. I have a stupid sense of humor. So whenever I, like, think about saying them, I'd be like, I just laugh, you know? Yeah. Oh, God. How's that Ray Zero music holding up? I think the Ray Zero music is good. I don't even know if I'll be able to download it. It might be like super copyrighted. Wow, I suck. I suck at talking. Exhibit A. Yeah. I still don't want the video to end. I don't know. Like, all right, okay, another thing. ASL teacher walks past us while me and Crush are talking, right? And like a whole 20 seconds after I tell her the words, I like you. ASL teacher walks past us. We're like, yeah, we're just chatting. Just chatting, yeah. It was terrible. Right, and yeah. Yeah. At some point, the day of the Garden Gram delivery, right? When school got out, I was walking past, I saw Crush, I waved high. But in front of me was one of the people who ran the Garden Gram thing. And I walked past them, hearing one of the person who ran the Garden Gram thing, saying like, I know who it is. And in the inside, I was just dying. Like, just dying of laughter. It was like, so ironic. I just walked past this, like, who in the funk? The guy who walks past them while they're talking about it is that guy they're talking about. Like, it's just hilarious. In my head, I don't know. If it's not funny to you, wow, I can't pronounce T's. What the heck? If it isn't funny to you, yeah, it's because I'm stupid and have a bad sense of humor, maybe. I don't know. Now I'm just repeating things. I really think I can end the video. I'm contemplating if I should make a performance review for the graduation. I think I will. Just because I don't have to just talk about like playing the music, because overall it doesn't matter how well I play the music. It's a giant stadium. It's a football stadium, right? And like, we're in the middle of it. Not everyone's even gonna hear the bell set, so whatever. Or the xylophone. It's more like, how well do I think I played? And how well did we like move stuff after? And maybe what happened. If I see Crush there, I'll bring that up, you know, it's stuff like that. 24 minutes, 25 seconds. Okay. As long as I don't edit anything, that should be what it was just now. Yeah. I don't want to end the video. Crush, I'm sorry for making you go through this. Unless, like, you thought it was a good experience, or, like, something. I don't know what I'm saying. If you felt like you learned something from this, I'm not sorry, but like if you just feel like it's a complete waste of time, which I don't know why you would, but if you do feel that way, I'm sorry. I'm sorry that the guy who sent the Rosegram had to be me, not some guy that you look up to or whatever. I don't know. I was like, yeah, when I sent the Rosegram, like a week later, I was like, huh. I wonder how depressed she'll be when she figures it out that it was me. You know, like kind of ironically, you know, like trying to make myself laugh, but like kind of seriously, like. Yeah. Anything else you would like to say to Crush? You're a good person? I mean, that's not wrong. Thank you for not making it super awkward. Because I mean, it's kind of in my control, but I feel like it's mostly in her control. I don't know. Thank you for existing. And yeah, this is the first time I confess to anyone, by the way. This is like the first time. So it takes me the end of junior year to finally tell someone that I like them. I'm so pathetic. I'm not gonna edit the video. Okay, I guess I'll talk about liking people. The thing is, if you ask someone what they like in a woman or in a man, what they say is most likely false. If they say they like, I don't know, long black hair, you can't know that they do for certain, because the thing that chooses who you like is like subconscious. Like, your conscious brain does not do that. Like, there's a difference between your conscious brain and your subconscious brain. Your subconscious brain is what chooses who you like. And you can't, like, consciously access your subconscious brain because it's subconscious. Okay, but like, so, I can't control who I like. Neither can you. I thought I could, but then I learned that's actually, like, impossible. So, I don't know if I'll still like her, like Crush. I'm gonna try not to, but like I said, it's actually out of my control. Excuses. But seriously, it actually is out of my control. But I'll like punish myself. I mean, not like physically, like, I don't know, take it. I don't know. What's a torture with? Like, what's good to torture? Like, I don't know, like, not torture, but like, take a baseball, chucking out my foot every time I think, hey, I like Crush. No, I'm not gonna do that, you know, but like, I'll be like, hey, don't think that. I mean, I don't know what I'll do. I'll create the mindset of, you shouldn't be liking this person anymore. And try to go with it. It's out of my control. Excuses. I know. She didn't make a different face when I said the words. Right, about saying the words. I don't think she understood that it wasn't so much about getting her to understand that I like her, but for me, it was more of saying the words, I like you, to her. So, like, when I said, I have to say the words, I like you, to her, right? I think it was a bit redundant, but, like, it doesn't matter. I don't think that she knew that there was more value in saying, I like you, to her, than there actually is. Like, it means more. It's symbolic. Not symbolic, but, like, okay. In English terms, yes, it was symbolic because it represents more than it actually is. Like, the lion represents being a lion and also fight whatever pride or whatever. Me saying the words "I like you" to her represents more than just me saying "I like you" to her. It's like me finally confessing for the first time, and like I was like, I need to say these words. That's it. Never done. I can be like, "Hey, Kay, I'm done. You can do whatever. Go home. Go eat with your friends. I don't know." Yeah. So that's why I said that. It might have been a bit redundant. Crush. I'm sorry if it was awkward. But I needed to say those words. It wasn't over until I said those words. It's all over. No, it's not. Summer's not here yet. Okay. But most of the things are over. Yay! I don't have to worry about stupid romance drama stuff. I think. Little did he know. Okay, I can't say that about myself. That just ruins my... Or that violates my be humble law of existence to myself. I don't know. Like, I follow principles. You know, like, stupid discipline. Like, how it's like, I'm going to tell her I like her, no matter what. Like, that's one of the things that, like, nothing will stop me. It's like, this is how I must live. It's like, once I decide I'm going to do this, it's going to happen. Another thing is, like, I'm going to be humble, like, at all times, and constantly call myself terrible. Most of the time, I do actually believe I'm not good at stuff, but, like, sometimes I think I'm good at something, but then still say I'm, like, bad. But that's, like, rarely. Yeah. Another thing is, like, staying true to your morals. Like, I don't jaywalk. Crush knows this. Like, one time after school, like, everyone was jaywalking, and she was like, "Are we gonna go?" And I was like, "No." That wasn't exactly how it went. I don't think either of us remember exactly how it went, but, like, it was basically like that. It's just, like, I don't want to be that person. I don't want to be, like, a rule breaker. Because then I associate rule breaking with, like, thugs who, like, deal drugs and stuff. And I'm like, I don't want to be that person. I'd rather not jaywalk. No, thank you. That's also, like, why I wear... That's why I wear a helmet whenever I scooter. Scoot. It's just like, I don't want to be that thug who doesn't wear a helmet and thinks he's so cool. No, I don't want to be that person, so I'm going to wear a helmet. And also, it's like, it's kind of a smart thing to do, you know? Like, I did. There was this one time in my life where wearing a helmet did benefit me. Like, I was scootering, right, on the sidewalk, and this is so stupid, no tree, right? And I didn't see the branch, but, like, there were, like, leaves in the way, so I couldn't see the branch, right? And, like, I kind of, like, ducked, right? But then it still hit my helmet. But if I wasn't wearing the helmet, the branch would have, like, just hit me, right? And I was going kind of fast-ish. I mean, okay, fast is relative. Physics. But, I don't know, 10 miles per hour on a scooter, that's kind of fast. Hitting a tree branch with your head at 10 miles an hour is also kind of fast, you know? So having a helmet didn't help me there. That was, like, the one time it helped me. It's like insurance, you know? It's just a smart thing to do. Yeah, stay true to your morals. It's like these things that I will make sure I do. And saying the words "I like you" to her was one of those things that I said I would do. 33 minutes, 45 seconds. End the video! But I don't want to end the video, but end the video! Alright, if I feel like there's more to talk about, I'll make another video. But for right now, this has been Seth, the laser sloth. I have been rejected, but not really rejected. Kind of rejected. In essence, rejected. I need to stop talking. Bye.